minus 10, 9, 8, ignition, liftoff.
All right, I would like to congratulate you for making it to the end of this lesson. You know, there are some people who buy courses and they don't even watch them. That is so sad, but not you. You are dedicated. I see you. And speaking of dedication, now is the time to dedicate yourself to practicing trimming on the timeline using the techniques that we covered in this lesson if you haven't been following along already. So I want you to practice previewing clips on the timeline, which you can do by dragging the playhead across a clip with your mouse, or you can use my custom keyboard shortcuts, FF to fast forward through a clip or SS to fast rewind through a clip. I also want you to practice selecting clips, which you can do, of course, by clicking a clip with your mouse, or you can press the D key, which will select clips under your playhead. You're also going to want to practice trimming clips on the timeline, which you can do by dragging out or in the edges of a clip with your mouse, or you can press the Q key to trim off everything before the playhead on a clip, or the W key to trim off everything after the playhead on a clip. I also want you to know how to split clips in two, which you can do using the razor tool, and you can get to that tool by pressing the C key, or you can use my absolute favorite custom keyboard shortcut, which is Shift G, which is going to quickly and automatically cut any clips at the playhead, and you don't need any special tools to do that. Finally, I want you to practice ripple deleting clips on your timeline, which you can do by right-clicking a clip and selecting ripple delete, or you can press my custom keyboard shortcut X when you've got the clip selected. And once you have practiced trimming on the timeline, I want you to go ahead and trim up the rest of the clips in your project, whether you're working on our picnic cinematic sequence footage or your own cinematic sequence footage. And you can use whatever trimming method speaks to you, whichever one you prefer. So you can do it in icon view, you can do it in the source panel, you can do it in freeform view or on the timeline like I like. And remember, you're not trying to get your clips in the perfect order or in the perfect sequence yet. We're gonna figure all of that out in the next lesson. But for now, I just want you to review all of your footage, trim out any parts that are potentially usable, and add those to your timeline. You just made my day for watching this to the very end. Sometimes you pour your heart into making something that you hope is really valuable and helpful to people, and you just always kind of worry, is anybody even gonna watch it? So the fact that you are here means so much to me. Thank you. As I mentioned at the beginning of this lesson, this is actually a preview lesson from my online course that teaches you how to make videos for your brand. And if you wanna know when the course comes out, then you can sign up for the newsletter, and I will give you a special early cat discount.